out by now, the theme for this year's battles is
peace.
So now that I hope you understand that, I'll use my regular glasses so we can continue on. So this is our annual event that encourages the love of reading and friendly competition between teams. Beginning in October, teams have been practicing, memorizing, writing questions, and now we're ready to celebrate all that we've accomplished. I'd like you to know that the Battle of the Books is sponsored by the Kenosha Unified School District, the Kenosha News, and Carthage College. I want to let you know that you'll be doing a lot of clapping tonight, so I appreciate you being enthusiastic because there's so many people to thank. I'd like to first of all acknowledge the student moderators who are here from Carthage College that are with us today. If there's any moderators with us, could I ask you to stand up, please? Oh, there they are in the back. Last week and tonight, we had a wonderful turnout of Carthage moderators. These students read the questions during the battles, and they will soon be the future educators of our children. So moderators, we have a little token of appreciation for you. We're giving you a special ribbon to say that you make a difference, and I know it won't be long before you will make a difference in the classrooms and in our children to come. I know not all the moderators stayed for the celebration, because what would a normal college student be doing on a Friday night? I'd also like to acknowledge all the parents who are here and thank you for letting your child participate in this program and for encouraging them to read and enjoy books. Would all the parents please stand up so we can applaud you? Administrators, principals, teachers who have come to encourage and cheer your school on. Would you please, if you are a visiting dignitary from a school, stand up. Principals, classroom teachers. Ms. Sue Valeri, who is the Director of Special Education and Student Support in our district. She'd like to say a few words to all of the teams.
Thank you. Thank you. 30 years. This is amazing. This is truly amazing. I would like to thank Kenosha Unified, Carthage, the Kenosha Public Library, and the Kenosha News for helping us put this on for 30 years. It truly is a wonderful event. Battle of the Books is offered to fourth and fifth grade students in elementary schools. And I'd say that the kids who do this have an opportunity, but it also takes a big commitment for these kids. They commit to starting in the fall and reading 35 books. 35 books. And then they work with their coaches in their schools to create questions, to discuss the books, and to conduct mock battles. Okay, all in preparation for this wonderful event. Okay, in these events, they've answered over 200 questions. And today I had the opportunity to watch some battles, and it was amazing. When I was an elementary principal, I used to watch the battles, and they were great. But today, I could not believe it. I watched battles where nobody got any questions wrong. It was phenomenal. It was record time. The work that you guys have put in is truly admirable. And I am so proud of all of you. So tonight, I'd like to celebrate the culmination of all your efforts from last fall. Congratulations to all the participants. In our books, you're all winners. Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Valeri. I'd especially like to thank Mr. Martin Pitts, principal of Nash, for hosting this huge event. We appreciate your wonderful hospitality and the use of this beautiful building. So we appreciate coming back for our third year. And I want to say your whole staff made us feel very welcome, from the wonderful people in the office to the custodians who set all this up for us. So we're very thankful to be here. This year there was a Battle of the Books committee that was formed to work together on this annual event. I'd like to acknowledge this wonderful team that I had the privilege to work with. The members of this committee are Miss Christine O'Regan over here. Mrs. O'Regan is the library media teacher consultant for our district. This is Shauna Edson from the University of Wisconsin, Parkside. And Mrs. Lisa Langsdorf from the Kenosha Public Library. These two ladies have the undaunting task of taking all your thousands of questions that you submitted and putting them into the battles. And believe me, you did a marvelous job, and we'll hire you back for next year, too. Dr. Marilyn Ward, who cannot be with us tonight from Carthage College, also is on our committee, and for many years has coordinated the student moderators and compiled the battles for us. We just want to applaud her and know that she has our support and thanks. And last of all, we have Mrs. Nana Cicero. Nana is the person who started Battle of the Books in Kenosha 30 years ago. Nana continues to be a big part of making all this happen, and who I rely on for her expert advice. Nana would like to come up and say a few words to you.
More than 30 years ago, a group of seven fifth and sixth graders in the Kenosha schools identified a problem, and then they set out to find a solution. The problem was, they didn't think kids in Kenosha read enough good quality books. Their solution was to start a citywide Battle of the Books tournament. Imagine seven fifth and sixth graders 30 years ago planning, preparing, conducting these battles. They were the moderators, they read the books, they did everything. Amazing. I think those seven students would be absolutely amazed that today, 30 years later, their initial work paid off and benefited you. And today, we have one of the seven student committee members here. She's here today. I don't think she realized then the importance of her work. I am sure it was, she is amazed by all that is happening. And I'd like to introduce her right now. Lisa?
Thank
age when she did this. Imagine. And here she is to celebrate after 30 years. So Lisa, thank you so much for joining us tonight and being part of this celebration. And also, Battle of the Books had a very ardent supporter over many, many years. Mrs. Sheard mentioned that we have a partnership with the Kenosha News. In fact, it was a committee like Lisa who went to talk to Mr. Howard Brown, who was then the publisher of the newspaper. And they asked him if they would, if the newspaper would please give us some publicity for Battle of the Books. Not only did he say, absolutely yes, he volunteered to buy all the prizes for the battles too, for the winners. So it was a group of students, again, who went to Mr. Brown and said what they needed to say, and he said, sure. So I'd like to just talk about Mr. Brown for a moment, because he was so special in our celebration. Are there any coaches here who have been coaching for maybe about 20 years or more? Anybody? A few. Perhaps you would remember when Mr. Brown would come to our celebrations every year. And Mr. Brown always had a story. And his story was about the beginning of the printing press. Gutenberg's printing press. He would share that story every single year and make sure that we all knew that that printing press printed the first book in mass production. And that book was the Bible. That's what he shared with us every year. But he didn't just share that. He always connected it to the importance of reading. And he always connected it to the boys and girls who participated on the teams. And then, of course, I'm sure for the parents, he connected it to the Kenosha News, too. Because that was where his heart and soul was. So we always want to remember Mr. Brown because of his support. And so today we have Mrs. Betsy Brown here with us to say a few words to you about Battle of the Books. And so I will introduce Mrs. Brown.
I'm just going to talk about the joy of reading. You all are winners. Some will take home a trophy, but all of you take home the joy of reading. Reading the printed page. Holding the book in your hands and feeling the paper and the rush to turn the page because the plot has thickened and you are anxious for the next event. You are reading about people, their situations, and their interacting with others. And these are experiences with which you can relate. You are reading for judgment, for knowledge. You are reading so you can ask questions. And you are reading to expand your neighborhood. I want all of you to carry this excitement with you as you explore your futures. And yes, you won't always be holding the book in your hand. Technology will allow you to read from a laptop and probably some other devices. Yet you will be reading full sentences, not words and shortcuts and acronyms. And please do not let your vocabulary suffer. As you read more difficult books and struggle with new concepts, always remember your intensity as you competed in the battle of the books. And congratulations also to your parents who have encouraged you and supported your love of learning from the printed book. And may you, parents, always have a book at your bedside.
You can go. You can this table.
Thank you, Mrs. Brown. I'm very thankful I had the honor of knowing her husband, Mr. Brown, and I always feel his presence with us every year. What would any local event in Kenosha be without having Elvis from our amazing Kenosha Kingfish baseball team with us? Often speechless, he would like me to tell you that the Kingfish are so proud that all of you are fantastic readers and participated in this year's Battles of the Books. Thank you to the Kingfish for encouraging students to read through your Kingfish Reading Program. Students who join the Kingfish Reading Program and meet their reading goals are treated to a free ticket to a Kingfish game this season, along with a free hot dog and soda. So Elvis hopes to see all of you out at Simmons Field this summer. Thank you, Elvis, and thank you, Ranger Bear. I'd like to give a gigantic thank you to the 70 coaches who since October have given countless hours of their time sharing their love of reading with your children. Those of you that are first-time coaches, can I ask you to stand up? Do we have any first-time coaches in here? Of Battle of the Books, and I know once you experience it, we know you'll be back next year to do it all over again, year after year. When we introduce the teams in a moment, I'm going to ask the three coaches from each school to please come up to the stage and receive just a little token of our appreciation for you. Is All Saints Catholic School. Let's say hello to Bose Elementary School. Hi there, Brass Elementary. And we welcome last year's first place team, Brompton. Edward Bain School of Language and Arts Dual Language Team. Welcome, Frank Elementary. Let's give a hand to Grant School. Hello, Greveno Elementary. Yeah. It's great to have Harvey with us. Welcome, Jefferson School. And let's applaud for Jeffrey School. Hello to the, now let me get this all out, the Kenosha School of Technology Enhanced Curriculum, better known as K-Tech East. And also, the Kenosha School of Technology Enhanced Curriculum, better known as K-Tech West. Let's give a big welcome to our host, Charles W. Nash School. Hello there to the Theodore Roosevelt School. Is St. Joseph Catholic Academy. Let's give a hand to Summers Elementary. Welcome, Southport. F. Stoker Elementary School. Let's applaud Curtis Strange School. And also Jane Vernon School. Would the team from Whittier stand up? And let's give Wilson Elementary School. The best books of 2016 is Miss Christine O. Regan.
To vote on their favorite books from each category. Here are the winners. fiction book, Number the Stars, by Lois Hart. For best nonfiction book, Sadako, by Eleanor Ford. For best biography book,
has a special announcement to make that we've been waiting for also.
Thank you. Yeah, thank you. Hi, once again, I'm Shauna from Parkside, and myself and my colleague Lisa Langsdorf from Kenosha Public Library are going to be announcing the winners of the Peace Poster Contest. As you know, the Peace Poster Contest was a new thing that we did this year. It was offered to students to express themselves through art. Students were challenged to create a poster about peace featuring a book or several books from the list this year. And they were required to meet a certain criteria of theme, size, color, medium, and they were chosen by the Carthage College students. 21 posters in total were submitted. And they are all displayed on the walls today. So if you take a look around, we have all 21 of our posters displayed with the winning posters directly behind us on the whiteboard. So as I announce the winners, I would ask that you please come up to the stage to receive your thank you. In first place, Kalia S. from Summers Elementary. Okay. In second place, Marcus C., Adore C., Jacob R., Ava R., Crystal A., and Elizabeth S. from Grant Elementary. In third place, Megan M. from the Brompton School. And in fourth place, Heidi F. and Erica B. from the Brompton School. Congratulations to all of the winners, and thank you so much to everyone who submitted posters. All of these lovely posters will be displayed at Kenosha Public Library after tonight, so you'll be able to see them at Kenosha Public Library. Let's give the Peace Poster winners one more hand.
I want to let you know that we will now call up the 6 top scoring teams to the stage in just a moment. And the teams that do not get called up to the stage, coaches, we have ribbons and those bookmarks for you to pick up in the front office on your way out. And now, the moment we've been waiting for. Here we go.
I want to see.
In 6 of 471 points is Roosevelt Elementary School.
Congratulations.
course since way back in October. In first place with 555 points is Epsola Dua.